On rainy days, do you see rainwater run off the roof, onto the sidewalk, along the street, and down a drain, instead of on your prized plants?
Welcome to the United States Department of Agriculture in Washington, D.C. I'm Leslie Burks, the project manager for the People's Garden, and I'm here to talk to you about rain barrels. So come on in.
So whether your motivation is the cost of water or just the health of your plants, a rain barrel may be a valuable addition to your garden.
Obviously, the size of your roof and where you live will determine your cost benefits to make it worthwhile. Now let's see.
Annual rainfall, inches of rain, roof area, volume of water, capacity and use. Got it. As you can see here, it doesn't take a large roof to make a difference. Your existing roof is the easiest way to capture water. Now slanted roofs use a gutter and a downspout. Well, flat roofs, they may use downspout or pipes to feed the rain barrel. Now let's take a look at our roof in action. And always have a sturdy lid fastened on it so only water goes into the rain barrel. Ours is store-bought. And we have it elevated, so we can use the middle bib for clearer water, or the lower bib, which may have more sediment. Let's see. But both should be high enough to fill a watering can. Now, I like to attach a hose to either, and then use gravity flow to water my plants.